Hi there, everybody, and fellow entomologists. I'm going to show you a nice preview today of some species that are going to be bred this year. All of this will be baby caterpillars, so it will be a video of small hatchlings of larvae that I have obtained. So let's go. These are really special to me. This is Automerus Janus from French Guiana. And the Automerus Janus is one of the biggest and baddest Automerus species in the world. They're very large, have a very large wingspan. And the larva will have a crown of toxic thorns. They will be really nice to see. If you want to see larva of a similar species, Google Automerus Metzli. Anyway, this is one of the biggest species I can obtain of Automerus, I think. Maybe some are bigger, like Postalbida, or from the Lara species group, I don't know. We'll see about that. Anyway, I really hope they will make it to adulthood. This will be one of the nicest larvae I'll have this year. Incredible. So, here we have hatchlings from Kenya. I am actually funding operations in Kakamega Forest in Kenya. I'm paying collectors to send me eggs. It's an expensive operation, but one that will be worthwhile. So, as you can see, there's a lot of larvae in here. I think there's about 100 or more. Most are hidden in the back, but we'll try and reveal them. So here you can see. See? And there'll be a wonderful Saturnidae from Africa, the Lobobunea Christi. Here some are eating willow. I've given them a lot of plants because there was not a lot was known about the host plants, so I just randomly give them plants to feed on, but they seem to eat everything. Here this is hawthorn, Crataegus, and they eat it. This is liquid amber, and they are eating the liquid amber. I included Prunus. As you can see, the Prunus padus, it's a big success. But also willow tree, salix. Here we have, see? So it's very polyphagous, which is good news for me. That means I can feed them nearly anything. So I do have a lot of these, 100. I really hope all of them make it, because rearing them in high numbers is difficult, you know, because they tend to get sick if you rear them in large numbers because of overcrowding. Larvae don't like overcrowding, and I have too many. These were imported directly from Taiwan. They're the Palyrisa cervina, an Eupterotidae, which is an interesting family I've never bred before. I believe these are second instar, but correct me if I'm wrong, they could be third instar, I don't know. Either way, their larvae will be very Lasiocampidae-like and hairy. Over time they will become completely yellow, which is nice. I don't often have bright yellow larvae. They have shiny blue metallic hairs and yellow. So, and last but not least, here is from French Guiana. Again, French Guiana. I love South American stuff. That's why. So let's see what we have here. I didn't have a lot of success with these, unfortunately. These are, here's one that's about to molt, about to shed skin. It's a common species in South America. It's a species that lives in the Amazon forest, but also in North America. It's Sisyphinx molina, and I had a lot of hatchlings of these, but I don't know, a few days after hatching the majority of them died, so that sucked. So here, as you can see, There we have a dead one. I have to remove it. I'm not sure why they keep dying. I think I might have picked a wrong plant for them. But it's... yeah, it's a shame. But I'm not complaining because I really have many beautiful species this year. And sometimes one of them doesn't make it. It's part of the hobby, you know, to fail. Failure is part of success. So yes, even I sometimes fail to rear some species. I don't know. I decided to give them... I forgot the scientific name. That's annoying. It's a Fabacea. It has these yellow flowers. Laburnum is the scientific name. I don't know the English name. Laburnum. So there's two of them left. Two or three healthy larvae of about 40 eggs. So that's not a lot, man. It's not very nice. Anyway, I hope the remaining survivors make it. Here's a healthy one. It's feeding from the laburnum, as you can see. Well, this won't be really a successful breeding, but maybe I can still film some adults if these make it. I don't know. Probably not, because these are just the last ones left out of many. Anyways, the others are doing very well. And these Automerus Janus, man, they're really one of my favorites. So if I can rear them this year, well, I don't care about the failures of the other species if I can rear that one. Thank you for watching. Goodbye. Whoa, I'm waving to the camera.